Sairam students, hope you all are doing well. Let's begin with the second session of geography, chapter number 1, resources. Before starting with the topic, let's have a quick recap of whatever we have learned in the last session. In our last session, we have seen the meaning of resources as well as the value of resources, right? In that meaning, anything that can be used to satisfy human needs, human desires, can be termed as resources, right? This is what you all learned. Then we learned about the utility. Utility or usability is what makes an object or substance a resource, right? Then further we saw about the value of resources. Value means worth. In that we saw some resources have economic value, whereas some have aesthetic value, right? Then we saw time and technology are the two important factors that can change substance into resources, correct? Then we learned about human beings themselves are the most important resource. It is their ideas and knowledge, inventions and discoveries that lead to the creation of more resources, right? We all have completed with this two topic. Now, today we are going to start with a new topic, that is types of resources. Now, in the types of resources, resources are generally classified into three main types, that is natural resources, human-made resources and human resources. But again, you can see the further classification is shown to you in the slide here, right? Natural resources are further classified on the basis of level of development and use, origin, stock, distribution. So, first we will deal with the natural resources, then human-made and human resources will be learning later on in the detail. Let's begin with the natural resources. Now, natural resources, from the word itself natural, you can understand. Resources that are drawn from nature and used without much modification are called natural resources. Now, everything given to us by nature, like air, water, sunlight, minerals, forest, wildlife, so many things, uncountable things are there if I'll start counting. So everything given and provided to us by nature is called as natural resources. Natural resources are classified into different groups depending upon their level of development and use. Okay, that is divided into actual resources and potential resources. Now, on the basis of level of development and use, we can classify natural resources as actual resources and potential resources, right? Now, let us see what are actual resources. Actual resources are those resources whose existence has been proved, whose location, quality, quantity has been determined. It means we all are very well aware about how much and what is the quality and where are these resources found. In short, if I want to explain you, I can say actual resources are those resources whose quantity is known. These resources are being used in the present. For example, we have abundant rich deposits of coal in Ruhr region of Germany. Similarly, there are massive resources of petroleum in West Asia. We have fertile soil which is found in the Deccan Plateau region of Maharashtra. So all these are included in actual resources. So all resources which are currently in use are actual resources. Since you already know their quality, quantity, as well as where are they located. So here, reserve is that part of an actual resource. Let me explain you about what is that reserve. It is a part of an actual resource which can be utilized at a sufficiently low cost with the available technology, but it is kept for future use. I can give you one simple example to understand that. For example, solar energy and geothermal energy, we still have to develop that level of technology so that we can produce them at a lower cost. So these resources are the resources which will be used in future. Currently, we are utilizing lot of fossil fuels. Okay. Let's move on to the next category, that is potential resources. Now, what are potential resources? Potential resources are those whose entire quantity may not be known and these are not being used at present. Now, all available resources may not be suitable for utilization with the help of available technology. Such resources, as well as the resources that have not been identified, are called as potential resources. So we are yet to find out the utilization of those materials in environment. So they are called as potential resources. Chintil, maybe the level of technology we have at present may not be advanced enough to easily utilize these resources. Now, the example for the potential resource here, it is given as the uranium found in Ladakh is an example of potential resource that could be used in the future. Now, let's take two more examples here. The force of flowing water and wind in the past were considered to be potential resource because we did not know how to use it. But later on, we developed the technology. We learned to generate power by utilizing them, and that is why today they are considered as actual resources. So I want to say you that the potential resource can be changed to actual resource with available technology, and maybe in the future it may be changed to actual resource. So children, now let's move to the classification of natural resources on the basis of origin. Here you can see on the basis of origin it has been divided into biotic resources and abiotic resources. Now, what is biotic resources? Biotic resources are living things such as useful plants and animals and human beings. It means all living creatures are included in biotic resources, right? Biotic means everything which is living on this earth, such as plants, animals, human beings, they all are considered in the same category, that is biotic. Now then, what is abiotic? Exactly the opposite of biotic is abiotic. Abiotic resources are non-living things such as metals, water, air, everything, whatever is non-living will be taken into consideration as abiotic resources. We have understood the classification of natural resources on the basis of level of development and use, and also on the basis of origin very well, right? So let's have a quick recap of what we have learned in this session today. Okay, we saw that resources that are drawn from nature and used without much modification are called natural resources, right? Whatever is available for us in nature, all are considered as a natural resources, correct? As the gifts of nature are given to us. Then we saw the natural resources are classified into different groups. That is on the basis of level of development and use, on the basis of origin, on the basis of stock, and on the basis of distribution. But today we have seen only level of development and use and on the basis of origin. Okay. So in that, the first one, level of development and use, in that we saw natural resources are divided in actual resources and potential resources, right? Further, we saw the meaning of actual resources as those resources whose quantity is known to us. These resources are being used in the present, right? Then we saw about the potential resources. Potential resources are those whose entire quantity may not be known and these are not being used at present. These resources could be used in the future, right? Then further, we saw the natural resources are classified on the basis of origin as biotic and abiotic, right? Abiotic resources are non-living, that is all non-living things are included in that. Whereas biotic resources are living things, correct? So this is what we have seen in this session, right? Okay. Whatever we have learnt in this chapter so far, you have understood it very well, right? This is what I feel, right? Then now here I have given you the activity. I hope you have already done with the previous activity. I hope so. If it is not done, do it immediately, okay? And just go through the today's activity. You have to write the two types of natural resources based on their origin as well as based on their level of development and use, okay? So see you in the next session with a further classification of natural resources on the basis of stock and distribution. Till then, take care.